And now, let us praise the humble dung beetle. In ancient Egypt, what we now know as the dung beetle, they called it a scarab, was worshipped. The ancient Egyptians believed that the scarab was a god that rolled the sun across the sky and buried it each evening, where it emerged the next morning, born anew. Today, you're much more likely to hear TV comics joking about dung beetles than find entire countries worshiping them. This is an outrage. Why? Because dung beetles are outstanding planetary citizens, performing a vital function. Dung is produced by animals we rely on for food, like cows. Without dung beetles, there'd be a lot more dung. Millions and millions of tons more. And that would mean a few billion more flies. Dung beetles like these in Africa put their heads down, their bottoms up, and use their super strong front legs to roll away this dung, help deal with the fly problem, and recycle the dung for a positive purpose. Male and female dung beetles work together to assemble a suitable dung ball as the centerpiece of their new home. One beetle burrows under the earth to help the dung ball settle in. This aerates the soil and helps the nutrients in the dung ball nourish the earth. Once the dung ball is settled in, the female lays her eggs in the new burrow. When the eggs hatch, they feed on the dung and prepare to begin this valuable renewal of the earth all over again. Dung beetles have been around for 50 million years, with 7,000 species worldwide, all united in their love of and need to possess balls of dung. One question about dung beetles for further study: are they capable of having fun? You know, being frivolous? We're not privy to the thought process of dung beetles. However, watch this sequence and decide for yourself. Now, we all know what fun it is to go to a theme park and take some wild ride that makes us feel like we're out of control. Is this the dung beetle version of this same giddy urge? No safety harness, no crash helmet. Whoa, that was wicked cool. No safety harness, no crash helmet. Whoa, that was wicked cool. The humble dung beetle. Because of it, we live in a better, less smelly world.
Now I have my goddess and my cartouche. I'll refer back to my list here. I'm going to choose a god or goddess. Done. Got it. Three objects that I'll need for the afterlife. Okay, I still need those. And my three symbols, plus I need water, which is this shape here. And I have have my name in a cartouche. Got those. So now what I need to do is use my packet to fill in the rest of that space. And let's see, what are my symbols? What symbols did I choose? I chose the Eye of Ra, Sama, and Leb. So let me check those. These are too small. These will be very small for the scratch art piece. So these are too small. You need to turn the page. Turn the page till you find the larger ones. I still have my tape on there. So I'm going to position this so that my Eye of Ra is directly above my goddess, but then I've got space there, so I really want to bring it in close, so I've got room for something at the top. So at this point, you're filling this in so that you don't miss any spaces. You want to fill in every single inch without them touching. You need to draw in shapes. Lines are not going to be as efficient or effective for you. Draw them as shapes, not lines. So the lines need to connect so that you fill in a space. Now let's look at my composition so far. I have a large amount of space at the bottom. I have a pretty large amount of space here. Would it be a good idea to put this right in the center of the space right here? If I did, then I have to find things to fit around it. So that would not be a good place to put it. Putting a small object right here would be a bad idea. I need to fill in my space. This fits in much closer. That's even better still. That fits in really closely there. So I'm going to put my symbol in there. I don't want to touch the edge of the paper. I'm going to fill it in space by space, but I don't want to go off the edge of the paper, and I don't want to touch the very edge of the paper because I need to transfer this on. You can make changes at this point if you like. If there's a symbol that you decide you like better or it works in your composition better, you can change it up. This ankh fits very nicely in between the cartouche on the left and my goddess on the right. That fits in there really nicely. Remember to make shapes. Oh, I ripped my paper. Remember to make shapes. Not lines. Your lines need to enclose an area to fill in a space. Now, luckily for you, I made a mistake that you might make, and I can show you how to fix that. All you have to do is try to flatten that paper out where you ripped it, turn it over to the back. Take a little bit of tape and fix it. Not a big deal. This is not your final piece. This is leading up to your final piece, so if you rip it, it's not a big deal to fix. So I'm just going to take a little piece of tape, not too big, I just want it big enough to fix that rip so it doesn't get any bigger, and I can continue. So I have my three symbols, I have my cartouche, I have my goddess, and now I can continue on with the things for the afterlife that I need. So I'm going to check my list, and I want to bring a phone, my computer, shower, toilet, my bed, my eyeliner, my clothes. I am not limited to three only. The packet says that I need three objects that I'll need for the afterlife. I'm not limited to that. I can use more. Now what I already have is I already have my ice cream in my hand, so I really only need two more. So I'm going to look in the back of my packet. Can't forget my cats. Okay, I'm going to put a cat in there. So I'm going to put my cat in next. Now this is touching. That will not work because that is touching, and when the shapes touch, they overlap, then that creates a problem because then it's hard to see the shape next to it. Let's see if this cat. Oh, that cat would fit in there very nicely. That cat fits right behind me, right under my ankh, and right next to my cartouche. So I'm going to go ahead and draw in my kitty cat. Meow. Now I'm going to put my tape down here because I need to do a little checking. I need to look and see if I'm getting what I need to on there. I can lift it up. If it's taped on one side, then I can open it like a book and check to make sure I have everything. This symbolizes a cat, but my cats are way fatter than this. They are so fat kitties. I have fat kitties. I think I'm going to take my iPod to the afterlife, but it doesn't fit right there. Fits there. I'm going to put it right there, and I'm going to bring it up so that it nestles in right underneath her arm so that it doesn't take up more space down here. I want to fill things in as I go really closely without touching. And remember, you are not limited to everything, to the things that are in the packet. You could do more. Now the rest of my space, I have already filled my criteria. I have everything in there that I need. There is nothing else that I'm required to put in there except I am required to fill the entire frame. So I have space up here, I have space down here. Now I think I'll look in the back of my packet, find the tab that says tomb paintings. And the tomb paintings have some really cool images in there that I would like to include. I think I want to include this bird, but I want that bird in there facing, I want two of these birds, one facing each direction. So I'm going to tape it down. I'm going to trace just the bird in this space right here, trying to get as much detail as possible without making it too confusing, but I want detail. I need to tape it on another place because it's starting to move. And these lines are kind of close together, so I'm just going to do every other shape. Because when we get to our scratch art tool, it gets a little bit difficult to get in there with that scratch art tool. So I'm going to simplify that a little bit. For every two of those feathers, I'm just going to put in one line. And then his legs. Now I want this bird facing the other direction too. I have to remember which is the front of my composition, because I need to make sure that all the lead is on the front. If I do it on the back, then I have to transfer it over. So I turned it over, now I'm on the back of my composition. I'm going to put my tape down so it doesn't move. I'm going to draw the bird again facing the other direction. And I'm going to simplify this. I need you to make sure that you make it as detailed as possible. But for the demonstration, I'm just going to do it quickly so you can get the idea. Then I have to turn it back over, because this is the back, I have to turn it back over, and I'm going to trace it again, this side, so that when I put the oil pastel on the back, it doesn't make it fuzzy, or smear it away. It's going to smear it. You'll see it will smear on the back of this, so I need to make sure that I have it drawn on the front and the back. Now I can go through and find any image that I want, keeping in mind that I cannot put things from this life into the afterlife. If I don't have it now, I can't take it to the afterlife. I'm going to put the sun god Ra. This is the sun god Ra, and this is a really nice one to take up space, to use up a lot of negative space. And I'm going to draw it by hand. I'm going to put the sun coming out from here, and then I'm going to draw hands coming out. Just really simple representation. And then with the sun god Ra, I can really fill up a lot of negative space easily. I still have a little space here that I could put something. Okay, so I've filled up all that space. Now I have a little space here, a little space here, and space here. So now I just need to find images to fill up those spaces, and I will be ready to move on.
goodbye. I owe somewhere over the rainbow bluebirds fly.
Stays away. Something in our minds will always
beneath that angry star, lest we forget how fragile we are. Tears from a star, like tears from a star. On and on the rain will say how fragile we are, how fragile we are.
Day of my life, swear I was born right in the doorway. I went out in the rain, suddenly everything changed. They're spreading blankets on the beach. Yours is the first face that I saw. I think I was blind before I met you. I don't know where I am, I don't know where I've been, but I know where I want to go. And so I thought I'd let you know. Yeah, these things take forever, I especially am slow. But I realized that I need you, and I wondered if I could come home. Time you drove all night just to meet me in the morning. And I thought it was strange, you said everything changed. You felt as if you just woke up, and you said, this is the first day of my life. I'm glad I didn't die before I met you. But now I don't care, I could go anywhere with you, and I'd probably be happy. So if you wanna be with me, if these things there's no telling, we just have to wait and see. But I'd rather be working for a paycheck than waiting to win the lottery. Besides, maybe this time is different. I mean, I really think you like me.
Carry moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are. Or would you rather be a mule? A mule is an animal with long funny ears. He kicks up at anything he hears. His back is brawny and his brain is weak. Just plain stupid with a stubborn streak. And by the way, if you hate to go to school, you may grow up to be a mule. How would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a pig? Hey, a pig is an animal with dirt on his face. His shoes are a terrible disgrace. He ain't got no manners when he eats his food. He's fat and lazy and extremely rude. But if you don't care a feather or a fig, you may grow up to be a pig. How would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home in a jar, and be better off than you are? Or would you rather be a fish? A fish won't do anything but swim in a brook. He can't write his name or read a book. And to fool the people is his only thought. Though he's slippery, still gets caught. But then if that sort of life is what you wish, you may grow up to be a fish. And all the monkeys on in the zoo, every day you meet quite a few. So you see, it's all up to you. You can be better than you are. You could be swinging on a star.
Cause I eat spinach, I'm Popeye the Sailor Man. I'm once up bazookas with chainsaw belugas waiting on me up and square. I fits them and busts them and always unrusts them, and none of them gets nowhere. If anyone passes to risk with this, it's pop and it's wham on a stand. So keep good behavior, that's your one lifesaver with Popeye the Sailor Man. Oh boy!
He's Popeye the Sailor Man.
Yeah.